So today we got a couple of great stories about mass adoption and where we're going as far as legislation for cryptocurrency digital assets. So first up, we've got Trevor Lawrence, who's probably going to be one of the number one or the top picks in the NFL draft. He just signed a deal with Blockfolio and will be paid in crypto. And at first glance, this is a great article. But when I really thought about it, being paid in crypto is like, it's just an awful, awful idea. And I'll explain exactly what I'm talking about. So we'll discuss that in detail. Then in some of the weirdest news today, U.S. state passes a resolution commending Satoshi Nakamoto and Bitcoin, and they pretty much just laid it out in the legislation. So you know what, this is great, and it's decentralized, and we want more of it. Yeah. So if you think that the powers that be and the lawmakers really want to ban cryptocurrency, well, here's a great story about how that is false. So we'll take a look at those two stories, but first, take a look at what's going on into the market. So today it is April 26th, and people always ask me, like, Rob, why don't you have another date? Well, there's two reasons. First of all, I do know the date most of the times, but sometimes I just kind of screw up the date, and then I get about 1,000 comments of going, it's this date, this date, this date. So to stop that, I always look at my phone just to make sure. Anyhow, April 26th, it's about 10 a.m. Nice day today. And here's what we got. So just so you know, we're doing pretty fantastic as far as the market goes. Quite a rebound. So I just want to commend everybody for buying that dip. I mean, if you did that, like I always talk about buying the dip for myself, I can't give you financial advice. Again, it's always about, you know, finding different voices out there and making your best choice for what works for you. And I got to tell you, buying that dip was a pretty good idea for me. And it worked out pretty great because we had quite a monstrous, just a big dump for a little bit after all that news about, first of all, there was Turkey and, and not that they're banning cryptocurrency outright, but and you can still use banks and everything else, but third-party payment processors not using cryptocurrency. Okay. Then Biden came out with his tax plan, going to tax everybody from 20% to 39.6%. And then the TA people came to me and said, oh, but don't forget about the technicals. Sure. So, and all those things all went together. It was kind of a bit of a dip. And we were under $2 trillion. Now we've been teetering. I think we're at like $1.86 trillion. Now we're above like 2.01 or something like that. So pretty good rally. Bitcoin is up 5% for the day. That's pretty great. Ethereum, I just saw it at 2,500. Now it went to 2,043. But again, up 5%, 15% for the week. Pretty great. Binance Coin, XRP, watch out, $1.26. Woo! So that's pretty good. And everything else is pretty much up except for Doge, down a little bit and a little bit all over the board. But I mean, that's great news and everything's good. But just the big thing for me is the sentiment. And just so you know, we're using Trade the Chain. Sentiment analysis does all the scraping for you. And this is my big thing. Long-term sentiment is always bullish, not always, but still bullish. Daily sentiment, even though we're at neutral, but look at these numbers. We were at 32, 34, 36, and now we're jumping in the high 40s, high 50s. And when we get to 60, we become bullish, like something like Uniswap. So again, I think 2021 is going to be a pretty great year. And that's where I see things going. And also one more thing, Solana is up 45% for 7 days, 5% in 24 hours. And if you don't know, Solana, man, that is a project that I wish I really would have gotten into. I just took a look at it, a little harder look today. And you know, I always like to invest in people. And they've got, first of all, people like Tether, USDC, Chainlink are building on Solana. You've got people who actually come from the world of Microsoft, Google, Dropbox, General Catalyst, Apple. They're all doing these things. And when I just take a look at that, and then they talk about transactions per second of 50,000, and then you can actually test their network to see if you can break it. This looks pretty good. And there's a lot of things being built on it. So network effect is in full effect. I'm not telling you what to buy. I haven't even bought it myself, but at some point I probably will after I take a harder look. And it probably goes up way higher. So that's what's going on. And then also, if you want to take a look at Trade the Chain, let me show you. Trade the Chain, if you're looking for sentiment analysis or whatever else, just in the description of all my videos, it's under Crypto Essentials. I got everything that you ever need. And there's a ton of different links in here, I know. But, I am the king of the shill. So we got a 100% free website, Dan Teaches Crypto. Kiva, where you can do microloans for, donations, things like that. T-shirts, blah, 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 everything else. But down here, right about here where it's got the little charts, trade the chain, send them analysis. Here's an explainer video of how it all works. And here's how you can sign up for it. And also I want to make mention of people I don't really talk about too much. And I need to talk more about these guys is if you're looking for like some nice artwork to hang wherever you're at, these guys do acrylic paintings and they source different artists throughout the globe. They make these really high quality stuff. Dogecoin's funny. And you can find all their information again in the description and you get 15% off with the code and a bunch of other stuff you might actually use like an extra wallet or a stone book, things like that. Anyhow, all right, so we've got that. Let's move into today's top story, which is all about Trevor Lawrence. You know what Trevor Lawrence is? He's this guy. And he is probably going to be in the top five pick for the NFL draft. If you're not from America, it's football. And everybody loves football. Well, for most people, a lot of people like soccer, but the most popular sport. But this guy here, Blockfolio came to him and go, hey, we understand that you are, you know, really into cryptocurrency. He's like, yes, let's make a deal. So he's going to be a spokesperson. And he says, don't pay me in dollars, pay me in crypto. Works out great for everybody, right? So when I see this article, the first thing I'm thinking of is, hey, that's pretty cool. He's going to get paid in crypto. And I think about it, I'm like, man, that's a bad idea. But there's a caveat, and I'll get to that right after I talk about this story. So Trevor Lawrence, former star quarterback for Clemson, blah, blah, blah. He signed a deal, right? The terms of Blockfolio's deal with Lawrence were not disclosed. Hint, it's probably huge. Lawrence is only being paid in crypto for the endorsement deal. And this is just going to, you know, get people to talk like, hey, this guy's coming out and he's getting paid in cryptocurrency. Then in May 2019, Russell Okung, offensive tackle for the Carolina Panthers, said, pay me in Bitcoin. And they actually paid him half of his $13 million salary into Bitcoin in late December 2020 when it was around $27,000, effectively doubling that half. So let me do some quick math. December 2020, January 2021, February, March, April, I got this many fingers up, so that's 4 months. In 4 months, you have doubled your investment. That's truly amazing. I mean, where else can you do that? Where else can you do that? So I think when people start to hear about these athletes getting paid in cryptocurrency, at some point they might go, you know, some people might be a little bit jaded and like, ah, that's stupid. Those young kids, I don't know what they're doing. But once you start to hear about these types of gains that they're getting, I think people are going to pay attention a little bit harder. And then it's just going to hit them from all sides. And like I talk about in marketing, you got to hear things 7 to 10 times before we actually jump all in. So this is just one more front of the advancement of the war, hitting people from all sides so they can actually get into this market before it really is too late. And then to finish up, it says recently the NBA team Sacramento Kings, as well as English Premier League Soccer Southampton, have announced they would allow their players to be paid in Bitcoin if they chose to. Hopefully they did it. Other teams have started to accept Bitcoin and crypto as form of payments like Oakland Athletics and the Dallas Mavericks. So that's all great. It's all fine and dandy, right? So what I'm talking about here, when I say to you, I'm like, man, that's a bad idea for to get your paycheck in crypto. Let's just take Bitcoin. It's just easier to talk about. So, I mean, I'm not going to talk about Tomato Coin or Solana, you know, getting paid in that. Let's just take Bitcoin, for example. So most people throughout the world do live paycheck to paycheck. I don't know if that's you. But a lot of people do. So like this, if you got paid this Friday in Bitcoin, well, you would have been up 6% doing nothing. How great is that, right? You get your paycheck, you're like, phew, I'm a genius. Didn't have to do squat. But here's the thing. That's if it works out right now. And then let's say a couple of weeks ago when there was a little bit of a dip of 5% between the time that you might have gotten paid, if you got to pay it Friday or Thursday, and then from the time you actually get to spend it on a Monday, because it clears in the banks suck, we know that, and actually to pay your bills, that's a problem. And then here's the bigger problem. The bigger caveat is this. When you get paid in Bitcoin or cryptocurrency digital assets, it's a taxable event. So you know that... If you get paid in that, and then you have to, you know, actually go through the process of cashing it out, well, then you're going to be, you know, for these taxable events. And that I think is a problem. And of course, it's all about the gains and loss and everything else. So I thought to myself, I'm like, you know, in all honesty, I don't know if I really want to be paid in crypto right now. I know people are like screaming at their screen going, that's so stupid. Why wouldn't I be paid in crypto? Well, here's the thing. Why don't you just take that money and then just purchase it the other way. I don't think it's a really that big of a deal. And then if you really look at crypto and you look at like a savings account and like an investment, I think that, what's his name? Trevor Lawrence. I think, you know, he's getting paid for this deal in Bitcoin, or in crypto. So I think for him, it actually makes sense because that's not his entire salary. And he's going to be able to actually put it into and just save it up and let it build. And he's got another salary and then he can pay all those bills and everything else. So I think it really just depends on what you want to do. For as an investment vehicle, it works out pretty great. But again, if you're living paycheck to paycheck, you're like, geez, I don't know, especially if things go down. Let's just say, for example, you get paid on a Friday and then on Monday, you know, when you actually get to spend, it goes down to like 10% or 20% because, you know, that's just how cryptocurrency works. Imagine losing 20% of your purchasing power and you have a hard time to pay bills. I think Bitcoin is a great idea as far as like an investment, but as far as the other thing, I don't think I would do it myself. Anyhow, let me know what you think in the comments section. Let's move on to our last piece. So, oh, actually, there was one more thing I want to talk about, and that is that if you're going to do use crypto as investments, you don't have to pay a ton of money. Like, I know like people ask me like, hey, I see these videos where people are putting like $5,000, $10,000, $100,000 into a crypto project. Where does that leave me? I can't do that. So there's this great website. It's called BitcoinDollarCostAverage.com. BitcoinDollarCostAverage.com. I'll link in the description below along with all my other links. So if you were going to, let's just say you started in 2017, which was December 17, 2017. That's when it was like really high. So let's just say that you put in, let's just say $25. And you want to put it in weekly. Let's just go there. So if you would have done that every single week, dollar cost average in, and just really didn't really look at it, didn't want to trade it, didn't want to do too much, today you would have 29,000. You would have put $4,400 in in like 4 years, right? And you only would have spent $4,400, but you would have had almost $30,000. That's just $25 weekly. So let's say you did, let's say you did $100 every week. You would have spent $17,600. I know it's a lot. It's like $400 a month, right? But you'd have $116,000 sitting in the bank right now. So if you start to look at these things and just go, you know, where should I be? What should I do? Well, you can go all in and we talk about that. But sometimes it's just good just to dollar cost average in and just go from there. Anyhow, let me know what you think about that in the comment section. Let's move on finally to our last piece. And this is interesting to me because it's fascinating that this can actually happen for legislation to just come out and go, hey, cryptocurrency is great. So what's going on here? So the Louisiana House of Representatives resolution by Rep. Mark Wright entitled Commends Bitcoin and the Crypto Industry has been enrolled and signed by the Speaker of the House. This is what it states. This is a resolution to commend Bitcoin for its success in becoming the first decentralized $1 trillion asset and to encourage the state and local governments to consider ways that could help them benefit from the increased use of this new technology. When I saw this, I was like, are we in crazy town? This doesn't make any sense that the legislation would come out and go, hey, Bitcoin is fantastic and it's really great. And we're actually going to put out a resolution to commend it. But here we are. 2021 is a crazy year. And if you don't think that's going to be huge, just look at this. The resolution proceeds to describe that cryptocurrency could potentially replace gold as a monetary reserve. Look, I don't care if you're a gold bug, silver bug. I don't care. I own both. Why don't you just own both? I don't understand the whole argument. Like, you got to have gold, you got to have Bitcoin. Stupid. Just get both and hedge your bet. And then it goes Bitcoins. It talks about Bitcoin's finite supply, 21 million. It's completely decentralized and allows for secure transactions without the need for a trusted third party. And then to finish up, it says it additionally notes that not only has Bitcoin proven to be a critical tool for businesses, it has proven to be a critical tool for citizens around the world to protect themselves from currency debasement. And then finally, it states, the House of Reps of the Legislature of Louisiana does hereby commend Satoshi Nakamoto for his contribution to economic security. So amazing. So again, I know how people say, you know what, this is bad news. Once we get regulation in there, it's just going to be awful, and it's going to, you know, bring everything down. Well, look, we need a little regulation. Little regulation goes a long way. It's like a slice of cake. You know, slice of cake's okay, but if you eat the whole damn cake itself, then it'll just kind of much ruin your night. So again, little bits goes a long way. Worked pretty well for the internets. The government was pretty much hands off, allowed everything to flourish, and it kind of gave people the right direction to where it didn't go too crazy, even though in some places it's a little bit off the rails, but whatever. So that's it for today. So look, if you liked that video, give it a thumbs up. That helps tremendously. Also consider subscribing. A lot of things we talk about are time sensitive. And don't forget, all the things we talk about are in the links below in the description. There's all the links, especially the artwork, Stone Book, link to Trade the Chain. That's it for today. So thanks so much for stopping by. I appreciate it. See you on the next one.